not see the morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see, he is alive. A grave that is empty, a promise fulfilled. God who was with us is here with us still. He is here, he is here, he is alive. For all your people sing alleluia. People of God, let your fear fall away. The chains have been broken, abandon your shame. Lift your hearts, he is alive. A promise fulfilled. Hear the fulfillment that once was foretold. It is true, it is true. He is alive. Alleluia, love is alive. Conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive. The sun has arisen for all. The people sing alleluia.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Patrick's. Before we begin today, we'd like to go over a couple things. The first one is our song for today. I'll sing it for you once, and I'll ask you to repeat it with me. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. Let's try it together. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. One more time, ready, sing. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. Very nice. And we're also going to sing the chorus of the song that we'll be doing for preparation of the gifts today. It's called Holy Spirit, and it goes like this. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Let's all try and sing it together. Here we go. Holy Spirit, sing.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
All right, very nice. So as we begin our celebration, as we continue our celebration, we want to make sure we welcome those who are here for the first time. So if you're here for the first time to St. Patrick's from a different city, state, or parish, we'd love to be honored by your presence and ask you to stand. So if you're here for the first time to St. Patrick's, please stand when we welcome you. There's some folks over here. Welcome to you. Thank you so much for joining us today to pray with us. I hope you have a great experience of liturgy today. And we also have another visitor today. This is Father Rob Clements from the Newman Center. If you'd like to welcome him, Father Rob Clements is over here. And Father Eric Tejas would be here to welcome and do this welcome, but he is not feeling well. His back is having some problems with sciatica. So he should be okay by next week, we hope. And if not, it'll be an interesting weekend. All right, so, but we want to go ahead and make sure everybody welcomes everybody, so everybody feels welcome. So please stand and say, hello, my name is, to everybody next to you. Hello, my name is. Thank you for welcoming each other and seeing the presence of Christ in one another. Let's take a moment to just quiet our hearts, quiet our minds, quiet our spirits. Maybe take a deep breath in. Maybe another for good measure. Ready? In the breath, we find the Spirit. So help us to be able to focus on the Spirit today, as we talked about in the gospel. We also ask you to help us to recognize that you are always with us, always present, in so many ways that we don't recognize you. Help us to recognize you more this week than we did last week. I invite you to sing with us. I'll sing first and repeat after me.
He is risen. He is risen. Jesus is risen. Jesus is risen. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, now is risen from the dead. Now is risen from the dead. He is risen. He is risen.
He is risen.
He is risen.
Jesus is risen.
Jesus is risen.
We will rise to face a new day.
We will rise to face a new day.
Building hope and trust again.
Building hope and trust again.
He is risen.
He is risen.
Let's sing the verse together. Renew us with your grace.
Renew us with your grace. We will find you when we're still. We accept where we are now. Lord, lead us as we go.
He is risen.
He is risen.
Jesus is risen.
Jesus is risen.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Now is risen from the dead.
Now is risen from the dead.
He is risen.
He is risen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
well, good morning, St. Patrick's. It's good to be with you this morning. I'm Father Rob Clemens, director of ASU's Newman Center. Special greetings to those who are joining us on Webstream this morning. Looking forward to sharing a few thoughts and about some wonderful things happening at our universities, at our Newman Centers, some tremendous possibilities. But as we begin the celebration of the Eucharist this morning, we call to mind our faults or failings and ask the Lord his pardon and his peace.
Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you make your dwelling among us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the heavenly city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And we join our voices together in praising God as we sing Glory.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Some who had come down from Judea were instructing the brothers, "Unless you are circumcised according to the Mosaic practice, you cannot be saved." Because there arose no little dissension and debate by Paul and Barnabas with them, it was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and elders about this question. The apostles and elders, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and to send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. The ones chosen were Judas, who was called Barsabbas, and Silas, leaders among the brothers. This is a letter delivered by them. The apostles and elders, your brothers, to the brothers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number who went out without any mandate from us have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have one accord decided to choose representatives and to send them to you along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey this same message by word of mouth. It is the decision of the Holy Spirit of us not to place on you any burden beyond these necessities, namely, to abstain from meat sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meats of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be
A reading from the book of Revelation. The angel took me in spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. It gleamed with the splendor of God. Its radiance was like that of a precious stone, like jasper, clear as crystal. It had a massive high wall, with 12 gates where 12 angels were stationed, and on which names were inscribed, the names of the 12 tribes of the Israelites. There were 3 gates facing east, 3 north, 3 south, and 3 west. The wall of the city had 12 courses of stones as its foundation, and on which were inscribed the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb. The city had no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gave it light, and its lamp was the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him. And we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away and I will come back to you. If you love me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Everyone, a lot of other priests will tell me sometimes, you know, Clements, you lucky dog, you've got one of the best jobs that a priest could have, the director of ASU's Newman Center, and you don't deserve it. I suppose that may be true, but I am, after all, a third-generation alumnus of ASU, Carey Business, 1984. And my parents met there. They were ASU students once, and they met. My grandparent, they went to the U of A. Never mind. Yeah, bear down over here. Okay. You know, that all that being said, I'm probably the only priest in all of history that can wake up every morning grateful to be able to say, "Go Devils," and mean it. You know, a professor from the philosophy department at ASU, he reached out to me. He goes to Mass at Newman, but he asked me to come and speak to his classes. Now, philosophy, there's a riveting subject if ever there was. But I think he had an ulterior motive, as they say. He introduced me to one of his students in the class, a sophomore guy, 19 years old. And it seemed to me that this young guy was kind of sad. Well, make the short story long here, he was raised by his mother. He never knew his father. And the only father figure he really knew was his mother's brother, his uncle. That uncle was a devoted Catholic, and this boy had never been raised with any religion at all. And then his uncle died very suddenly, and the boy was devastated. But he attended his uncle's funeral, which was at Our Lady of Mount Carmel, venerable Tempe Parish. And to hear him say it, he had never known that there could be such joy, even in what seemed to him to be a great tragedy. He had never known such kindness from people who were complete strangers to him. And he was deeply moved by the Mass itself. Now, in one setting, what does he experience? Truth, beauty, goodness. It was the spark that would set him on a course to enter the RCIA at Newman Center, where he was initiated as a Catholic, baptized, confirmed, the works. He would graduate with honors, and just last year, we sent him off to the seminary to start studies for the priesthood. You know, I'm part of a profession. I got to find my own replacement. So, but everyone, you know, a Christian's religion, you know, well, Christians believe that God has given it to us. He has taught us what to believe. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. The Spirit, whom my Father will send in my name, will guide you into all that is good and true. God has taught us how to live. This I command you, love one another as I have loved you. He has taught us how to pray. When you pray, pray like this: Our Father in heaven, hallowed is your name, your kingdom come, your will be done. He has taught us how to worship even. Do this in memory of me. And then there's that other voice that's been around since the Garden of Eden that says, has God really said all this? Has he? Has he really said this? Yeah. Okay, let me tell you, everyone, that voice is still around, and it doesn't whisper, it shouts in a university setting. You know, some terribly destructive ideas and movements that emerge in our university, such to cause young adults to question today even what it is to be a human being. Is life worth living? Is it right and fair to bring children into the world to see life? Well, St. John Henry Newman, for whom Newman Centers are named, he had something really unique to say, but he said, each of us is the result of a thought of God. Each of us is willed, each of us is loved, each of us is necessary. And Cardinal Newman envisioned that Christ should be engaged in the life of a university, if only to challenge the bad ideas that can destroy us, ultimately. That's what a Newman Center is, the presence of Christ in a university setting. Now, how do we engage 100,000 students like at ASU? Well, pretty much how Jesus did, one soul at a time. Just by being there, don't judge, listen well, answer questions thoughtfully. Call people to something higher: truth, beauty, goodness. Truth, well, remember Pontius Pilate's the one that asked truth. What is that? Well, university, the mind gets stretched, for sure. But I have a secret weapon at ASU, Mary College at ASU. You know, just about 10 years ago, Monsignor Jim Shea is the president of the University of Mary in Bismarck, North Dakota. He shows up at my door with this harebrained scheme. He wants to establish a satellite campus of the University of Mary on site at our Newman Center, a satellite campus in the thick, in the middle of ASU. Well, let's give it a go and see if it happens. He cruises across the street to the university administration, knocks on the president's door, Dr. Crow, and you know that he walks out of Crow's office with a full-blown academic partnership so that students at ASU, any student at ASU, can take theology or Catholic studies courses at Mary College, and students at the University of Mary can take general studies at ASU, and it all counts. It's for credit and counts toward a degree. That's quite a deal if you think about it. You know, now, there's 100,000 students, 25% of them, that's the national average, are Catholic, so that's 25,000. There's a lot of Catholic students wandering the malls at ASU, and we got a setting where they can learn their faith real well, you know, study things. Yeah, go Devils, you know. How about beauty? ASU Newman Center, it is a beautiful place, you know. Human beings, they need the visual. They need to be able to see, you know, to connect, if only to counter some of the horrible images that can flash across our phones and our screens in an instant. Now, we take some pride in having a beautiful chapel, lively sacramental life, adoration every day, confession 6 days a week. They need it. There is something for anyone that you'll find there. I mean, I think our masses are wonderful celebrations of beauty, truth, goodness. You know, if you're a trad, si querías celebrar la misa en español, we've got you covered. Music ministry, I think that's so important. It really is, especially an experience of beauty. You know, when I was a student, and it's still there at ASU, and that was put in place decades ago. In fact, when I was a student at ASU, we won't go into when that was, but who was doing music at Newman at the time? None other than Paul Hildebrand. Paul, I hope I'm not aging you. And then there's goodness, people, community, life, that sense that I fit in, that I belong. You know, St. Patrick's, you all know what community is here, because I see it. Over the years that I've been at Newman, that's 12, some of our most active students and members in our community have come from St. Patrick's Parish. In fact, we're getting ready to send one of your finest off to the seminary this fall. Well done. Anyhow, it's with all this in the background that Bishop Olmsted kicked off the Together Let Us Go Forth, Juntos Sigamos Adelante campaign. And one of the principal areas of concentration is our Newman Centers at ASU, at NAU in Flagstaff, at GCU, Grand Canyon University in Phoenix. I'm thinking that we're going to be adding another one at ASU downtown, because ASU has just gotten to be a monster out of control. But I think the bishop especially wanted to emphasize Newman Centers because that's our future. We have to have a heart for our young people who are easily in the most formative time of their lives when they enter college, a time when decisions like marriage, career, even religious practice, it all hangs in the balance, and Christ must be there in the thick of it. Everyone, I hope you'll have a chance to join with us and get behind this campaign. Consider a pledge. Come by and see us after the Mass. There's a table with displays on it. You can get more information. I can share with you some of my secret plans for our center at ASU, but I'll just be lurking out there. That's what I do best, is lurk. But Paul, I think we've got some announcements as well.
Thank you, Father Rob. So I mentioned Father Eric, and he'll be hopefully back next week. There's a lot of information out here about this diocesan campaign, so I encourage you to do that. And to follow up on Father Rob's story, I am very grateful to have been through the Newman Center, especially at ASU, because two things happened. First of all, I probably would be teaching music in a high school somewhere, and instead I'm here at St. Patrick's, specifically because the priest there called me on Ash Wednesday morning and said, "Can you come and sing?" And I said, I got a class. I can't do it. I'm backpedaling as fast as I can." And he said, "Well, just come sing Amazing Grace." And I said, "Okay." And basically, I've been playing at church ever since. So And then, number two, I met my wife at the Newman Center. All right, then. So, also, families, if you're interested in summer opportunities for your children, for youth from Vacation Bible School to teen retreats, please come and look into the bulletin and in the website to find out. There's a lot of stuff to do this summer. There's a wonderful water drive, as we always do. It goes through June 12th. We're trying to go ahead and raise 350,000 water bottles. Last year, we were able to do that, even though we were in the middle of COVID. It's fine if you bring water, but if you'd like to save your back, you can also donate, and that's wonderful, too. There's a Catholic Charities table after Mass. Paul Bradley, our Catholic Charities champion, will be there to share information about the multiple services Catholic Charities offers. And last but not least, maybe most important, the Knights of Columbus are offering a free pancake breakfast in a Fenland Hospitality Center. So please come and join them. That is free, but there is a bucket there, I'm pretty sure. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you, Father Rob.
We are an Easter people, so let's rise and profess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Jesus told his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled." We bring before the Lord all that threatens to trouble our hearts, turning to the source of everlasting peace to bring that peace to our hearts.
For the church, that we may always be attentive to the creative work of the Spirit, so that many may encounter Christ without unnecessary burdens. We pray to the Lord. For world leaders, may they have wisdom in discerning new economic policies that may relieve stress and pressure from our daily costs of living. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims and their families of the shootings in Buffalo, New York, and for all who are victims of shootings across the country, may our conversations recognize the pain of those who are suffering first before speaking of political thought, and may leaders everywhere engage in serious discussions about solutions for the safety of all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Newman centers in our state that serve the spiritual needs of college students, may they continue to accompany our young people on their faith journeys during their young adult years. May our parish community respond to the needs of the Newman Centers as we work together to support young adults who are finding their place in the greater Christian community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all students who are graduating this year, may they take with them what they have learned and boldly go forward to find new purpose and make the world a better place. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, may they be given the strength and hope needed for healing. We pray especially for Dee Dee Mellian, Jean Cerrone, and Lucia Dominguez. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they enter swiftly into the holy kingdom of heaven. We pray especially for Cooper Thomas, Erica Martinez. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you promise to dwell with all who love you and keep your word. Do not let our hearts be troubled as we place our trust in you. Grant this in all our prayers through your Son, our risen Lord and Savior. Amen.
We invite the ministers of hospitality to come forward now with the baskets so that we can bring our offerings that we've brought together, whether they're offerings of giving, praying, or serving. And as we sing together, Holy Spirit, we invite you to come forward with your offerings. Thank you very much. Thank you.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our living home. Your presence. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
I've tasted and seen.
I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit,
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unceasing hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full.
You are in indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore,
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, and with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we have the courage to sing.
Our Father who art in heaven, this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
for the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace. Good to celebrate with you today.
Great homily. Thank you. It brought it down to earth, you know?
Hope so.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please sing with us now as we come forward to receive Jesus in the Eucharist.
Let no one caught in sin remain inside the lie of inward shame, but fix our eyes upon the cross and run to him who showed great love and bled for us. Freely you bled for us. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Beneath the weight of all our sin, you bow to none but heaven's will. O scheme of hell, no scoffer's crown, no burden great can hold you down. In strength you church proclaim. Christ Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Oh, death, where is your sting? Stand in the light, the glory of God has defeated the night, singing, oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, hell, where is your victory? Oh, church, come stand in the light, the God is not dead, he's alive, he's alive. Trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. I know that I Redeemer lives, the one who calls me home. I long to see God face to face, to see with my own eyes. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that I shall one day see the goodness of the Lord, when God will wipe away our tears and death will be no more. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know shall rise Savior, isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah, bow down before him, for he is Lord.
Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to life eternal in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Everyone, I want to thank Father Eric for his gracious invitation to have me celebrate with you this weekend. It's been delightful to be with you. I'm sure there's lots more news and information found in your bulletin. Pick up a copy as you leave Mass, and have a great week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Spirit, take hold of my life. Give me every gift I need. Holy Spirit, my heart on fire. Let your love be seen in me every day. Spirit of counsel, Spirit of wisdom, be seen in me. Spirit of understanding, be seen in me. Be seen. Your love be seen in me every day. Spirit of knowledge, Spirit of quivenance, be seen in me.
I can't walk and chew gum at the same.
Spirit of right judgment, be seen in me. Be seen. Holy Spirit, take hold of my life. Give me every